Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thankful to be in the house of the Lord one more time.
Amen. Yes.
Thankful for a new day. Thankful we made it down Roosevelt Boulevard. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Because we didn't think we were going to. Amen. Now time to praise the Lord. Yes. Give him the honor and the glory he deserves.
Yes.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
My Father's house. If it were not so, I would have told you. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Just happy to be in the house of the Lord. Happy to be in the land of the living.
Yes.
Just grateful because God is a good God. Amen.
Yes, he is.
When you got God's favor, it's a good thing. Amen.
Yes.
And if God is for me, he'll do the same thing for you. Don't worry about
that.
He's going to be with you.
Love is patient, caring. Love is kind.
Love is felt most.
Love is felt most when it's genuine. Manipulated and estranged, misused, and I can't help but give you glory.
When I think
about my story, but couldn't triumph over me. Hallelujah. They can't triumph over you with God on your side. Amen. When God has favor in you, no one can triumph over you. Amen. Amen. Love is patient, caring. Love is kind. It's felt most when it's genuine. But I've had my share of love abused, manipulated and estranged, misused, and I can't help but give you glory. My enemies did try, they couldn't triumph over me. Yes, they tried, but couldn't triumph over me. They whispered, conspired, they told their lies. God favored me, my character, my integrity, my faith in God. God favors me. Won't I fall? Will not bend? Won't compromise. God favors me. I speak life and prosperity, and I speak health. God favors me. They whisper, conspire. They told their lies. God favors me. My character, my integrity, my faith in God, he favors me. Will not fall, will not bend, won't compromise. God favors me. I speak life and prosperity. I speak health. God favors me. They whisper, conspire. They told their lies. My integrity, my faith. When they speak lies, God favors you. They will not triumph over you. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Because God favors each and every one of us. Amen? Amen.
I don't know what you're going through, but I want you to find.
Yes, God favors in your trials, in your tests, in your hard times. Don't worry, because God favors you. Yes, they attack your integrity, but don't worry, because God favors you. They touch your neighbors, encourage the person next to you. Tell them, and say yes, because God favors you. Amen? Amen. Yes. God favors me. Through your crisis, your difficulties, God favors you. Through all those hard times, God favors you. Amen? Yes. Yes. God favors me. Yes. 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 God favors me.
Wonder why I did not die.
Wonder how you made it through the storm. Wondering how you're still here today. No more fake friends. You can say goodbye to all of that because God favors you. Amen? Amen. But I have the same reply. God favored me. Once the evil bring us down. But God says it again. I rise. God favored me. Good God and the all-time God, and He favors each and every one of us. Amen. Amen. Wakes us up every morning. Will not let the enemy triumph over us. Amen. Because God is on our side because He favors us. He calls us friends. Amen. We make it here every Sunday. We wake up every morning and we have nobody to thank but God. Amen. Amen. Because God is just a powerful and almighty God. And all He wants is our prayers. Amen. All He wants is our thanks.
Oh, life, You satisfy me. Yes. You satisfy me. With long life, with long life, You will satisfy me. You will satisfy me. With long life, oh, I will praise You forever.
I'm gonna do my dance.
the middle of it. The battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Amen. In the middle of it. The Lord knows what you're going through, so praise Him in the middle of it. Amen. When you're down, when you're hurt, you praise Him in the Lord. You praise the name of the Lord in the middle of it. Clap your hands, stomp your feet, do your dance, but praise Him in the middle of it.
In the middle of it. In the middle of it.
Because the Lord is also good. He deserves every praise we give Him. A clap, a dance, a shout. We praise the Lord in the middle of it. Because the Lord gives us blessings each and every day. He wakes us up each and every morning. That in itself is a bless in the Lord. Amen? Amen. We are blessed. The Lord sees favor in each and every one of us. Amen. Amen. How could you not be happy to praise the name of the Lord? Being blessed in His presence. Amen. Being happy to be in the house of God just one more time. Give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Amen. Blessed in the name of the Lord. Your prayers, if not all of your prayers. If the Lord answers one prayer, consider yourself blessed. Amen? Amen. Because our God is a good God, isn't He? Isn't our God a good God? Amen. Amen. Wherever we go, because the Lord will take down any stronghold that has you. Amen. Amen.
We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold. Sickness and poverty will cease. For the devil is defeated.
We are blessed. the Lord and following God's word, we are blessed beyond what we even know. Sometimes they say, you know, when you pray, you may be praying for something, but you're not ready to receive that blessing that God has for you. Make sure you're ready to receive God's blessing. Make sure you're ready to receive what God has for you. Amen? Amen. How many people do you know you can say Tommy's name and the devil's going to flee? Tommy may be the devil. So you can say the name of Jesus and the devil will flee. Amen. Amen. I am thankful to be in the house of the Lord. I am thankful that we made it, like I said, down the highways and the byways, down Roosevelt Boulevard. You know, people that drive down there can't drive. Turn signals were non-existent this morning. So I'm thankful we made it today. Amen. God, he's a protector. He was our hedge of protection coming around here today. Because we so greatly needed it. Amen. It's not about the way we drive. We got to watch out for the other drivers on the road. Amen. And I'm just glad to be in the house of Job. Like I said, just one more time. Glad the Lord woke me up this morning. Started me on my way. Started my baby on her way. She's a rambunctious little thing running around here in the pink. That's mine. But she's happy, she's healthy, and I give it all honor and praise to the Lord himself. Amen. Amen. Now the time of our testimony part to tell God what he's done for you. Tell God how good he has been to you. To tell God about what he has brought you through. Because there's a song that says, I got a testimony and can't nobody tell it like me. Can't nobody praise him like me. Because this is your testimony. This is your time to talk to God and tell him you're thankful. Tell God you appreciate him. And sometimes I tell people, you know, all the time I tell people, you got to stop asking God for things. There's a time and a place to ask God for things, but there's always a time to give God praise. Sometimes our prayers need to be praises instead of an asking prayer. Praise God. Thank him. Just give him prayer and say, God, thank you. God, thank you for just thank you for letting me be right here, right now, on my knees, giving you honor, giving you praise that you so richly deserve. Whether you bless me with nothing else, you bless me enough to keep me in the land of the living one more time. Amen? Amen. And that should be everybody's prayer. Every day is just to wake up and thank the Lord. And that's my testimony. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. God has brought me and my family through a mighty, mighty lot of things. And he brought us a mighty long way. And losing my dad, losing my stepdad, we've lost aunts, we've lost uncles, you know, my mom's lost brothers, and we've lost cousins, and we are all still here today. God has seen us through some trying times, losing jobs, moving out of homes, you know, financial situations where you can barely get food on the table, where you can barely buy diapers for your child, where you're up all night stressed out about money. How's this gonna get paid? How's that gonna get paid? But you know, you gotta give it to the Lord. You gotta let him take control. You gotta let him drive the car. You stop driving the car and let God drive the car. Because those bills are gonna be here when you're dead and gone, and you're stressing about something that honestly you have no control over. Because God will make a way. The Lord always provides, and we just gotta trust in him. And that's the whole big thing, is trusting in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not to our own understanding. In all ways acknowledge him, and let him direct your path. You don't direct the path. Let him direct your path, because you just need that small faith the size of a mustard seed to keep on going. Amen. You need that faith the size of a mustard seed. A mustard seed is very small, and for a lot of people that's giving up too much. But how is giving up that much compared to what God gives us? God gives us life. God sacrificed his life so we would be able to repent our sins, because we mess up. And people think they're perfect. You're not perfect. There's nobody on this world that's perfect. The one that was perfect is gone. And he's gone. There is nobody here that's perfect. And when the faster we realize that and we seek the Lord, the better off this world will be. And I just kind of imagine this world just, it would be so much better if our prayer warriors were strong and on the front line. Instead of people with guns, how about we have some people with Bibles saying prayers?
Yeah.
How about we have some prayer warriors out there instead of people with guns blowing each other's heads off?
Yeah.
How about we have people in the churches go outside the churches and pray for people outside of these walls? Pray for people in this world. I say, you know, when we say prayers, we shouldn't call names, because the whole world needs prayer.
Yes,
let's just pray for the world.
Yes.
And especially these little kids that are growing up in this world today. I'm scared for my daughter, because so much goes on in this world today.
Right.
And I just pray over her and let God cover her, because that's all that I can do.
Yes.
Amen? Because God is all we need. God is all we have. I would rather have the Lord on my side than a gun in my pocket.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because that's a stronger weapon than anything anybody else has got out there. Because with that weapon, no weapon formed against you shall prosper if you have the weapon of the Lord in your back pocket. Amen.
Amen.
So to start our testimony.